Hi everyone, Radhe Radhe. In this video, we're going to be doing chapter 14, verse 21. And Arjun now speaks and he asks very good questions. He asks three questions. And let's go dive in. Let's call out to Bhagwan Shri Krishna and pray. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Dear Bhagwan Shri Krishna, please help us understand this. Arjun is asking an amazing question. Please help us understand the depth of this question and the answers that Bhagwan Shri Krishna gives in the future. Please help us by bringing us closer to you. Please be pleased with us. Please be pleased with us to intensify our attachment to you. Please be pleased with us and open those doors for us, because it is completely your will and your choice when you open those doors of bhakti in us and prema in us and love in us. Please, please open those doors for us. Please bring us closer to you. Please bring us closer to the truth. Please bring us closer to real love. Please bring us closer to ecstatic real love. Okay, let's sing the verse together. कैर्लिङ्गै स्त्रीगुणान् नेतान् अतीतो भवति प्रभो कमाचारः कथं चैतां स्त्रीगुणानातिवर्तते. This one is a mouthful. Okay, Arjun asked, O my dear Lord, by which symptoms is one known to be transcendental to these three modes? What is his behavior and how does he transcend the modes? So the very important questions he's saying. Unless one knows how to be situated transcendentally, we don't know how to become transcendental and show the systems. So symptoms. So he breaks it down very methodically. I really love how Swami Upananda breaks things down so methodically. He says he now asks three questions which Bhagavan Shri Krishna will answer systematically. So lingas means symptoms. So the first question is, what are the symptoms of those who have transcended the three gunas? Acharaha means conduct. In what manner do these transcendentalists conduct themselves? Ativartate means transcend. How does one transcend? So this is, first of all, this is to note, this is talking about beyond the three gunas. He's not talking about mode of goodness. He's talking about the transcendent mode of beyond the fourth stage, the transcendent stage. So what are the symptoms? What does the person look like who has transcended? What do they do? How do they behave? So what are the symptoms? How do they behave? Is kind of similar questions to me. I'm not sure exactly the difference between them. You know, what are the symptoms? Like maybe what do they look like and how do they behave? Maybe that's the difference, or something like that. And the third question is the most important question, according to me, is how does one transcend? What do we do to transcend? So I am thrilled. I'm thrilled that we're going to get the answers to these in the next few verses. There are 27 verses in chapter 44. So in the next six verses, most likely, we're going to get the answers of how to get there. Thank you, Bhagavan Shri Krishna. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, so that's it for this verse. We'll do chapter 14, verse 22 in the next verse, next video. Wish you a day filled with lots and lots and lots of Bhagavan Shri Krishna's grace. Radhe, Radhe.